Dr. Chandan Mitra.
Chairman, I rise to second the motion of thanks to the Honorable President of India for his address to the joint session of Parliament. Sir, at the time of independence in 1947, our leftist friends, most of whom are not here right now, I see, used to coin a slogan. It was, Maang raha hai Hindustan, roti, kapda aur makan. Now, nearly 70 years after independence, we are still struggling. We are still struggling to provide housing, clothing, food, education for all, and it remains a distant dream. Prosperity has come to India. It's not that prosperity isn't there, but it has come in a totally distorted fashion. India has some of the richest people on the face of this earth and also some of the poorest. The NDA government, led by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, is committed to fulfill the unfulfilled dream at the time of independence for food, clothing, housing, quality education and health for all. The government's commitments are guided by a philosophy which was outlined by the President in his address. At the outset of his address to Parliament, Mahamahim Rashtrapati Ji pointed to the holistic philosophy of Ekatma Manavvad or Integral Humanism envisioned by Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. As my colleague Sri Bhupendra Yadav has already mentioned, at the core of this philosophy is the empathy and commitment to the poor and downtrodden, the last man in the queue, so to speak. The Honorable President has expounded the entire range of programs initiated by this government to put the last man first in the scheme of things. Swami Vivekananda, the greatest Indian sage of modern times, had evolved the concept of Daridra Narayan. Now, what does Daridra Narayan mean? Daridra Narayan means that God truly resides in the poor. Or if you worship God, you have to take care of the poor. Without taking care of the poor, your worship in temples and mosques and churches is meaningless. Sri Narendra Modi's government has embarked on this mission with this object of Daridra Narayan, the philosophy of Daridra Narayan in mind. Each and every new program of this government, as enunciated by the President, is directed towards achieving this goal. It is painfully apparent that the former, who provides sustenance to the country's 125 crore people, lives in abysmal poverty. India's villages remain dirty, schools and health centers are rudimentary, and kisan's huts are ramshackle. Most places don't have electricity. There are no connecting roads. Much effort has been taken in the last few years to upgrade this, but still it's a long, long way to go. Without improving the living standards of the poor farmer, without upgrading the quality of their life, India cannot prosper, sir, India cannot be a happy country. The President, therefore, has rightly pointed to our fundamental civilizational value, Annadata Sukhi Bhava. To ensure the happiness of the kisan, the government has announced a series of new schemes. To ensure irrigation benefits reach every village, the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana is being launched. To help the marginal and resource-starved farmer with techniques of organic farming and greenhouse technology, the Rashtriya Gokul Mission, which will also conserve and develop indigenous cattle breeds, is being initiated. Provisions of the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act are being marginally remodeled to help develop durable assets in the villages in order to improve the quality of life in rural areas. Sir, the MNREGA has been in operation for many years. But even if you go and visit some of our interior villages, and I have done that as part of parliamentary committees, we find that villagers feel that durable assets are not being built. They say that true drains have been dug, canals are being dug, but schools, which are an utmost necessity, need to be built, hospitals, child care centers need to be built, but these have not been done. Sir, I hope that the government's new programs that are being initiated will enable MGNREGA funds to be used for this kind of durable asset creation. The President has also revealed a slew of schemes targeted at the less privileged sections, SCs, STs, OBCs and minority communities. For the benefit of tribal people living in remote forested areas, the Van Bandhu Kalyan Yojana and the Nanaji Deshmukh scheme are being launched. The challenge today is to ensure sustainable agricultural growth and put more money into the hands of the farmer. This can be done only through the better quality of their produce, which commands a better and higher price in the market. This in turn can be achieved only through serious emphasis on food processing. The President has announced the government's decision to create a fund of rupees 2000 crore to provide affordable credit to food processing units in 72 notified food parks. In the last 6 months alone, 30,000 direct and indirect jobs have been created through two mega food parks at Tumkur and Fazilka. More will need to be created. While a chain of cold storages, better connectivity between farms and marketplaces, etc., will help to reduce the supply chain losses, which is essential, sir. The farmer is producing and his produce is not getting a fair price. There are times when there is a glut in the market, and I have seen it in many parts of the country. Potato, for instance, which we in the metropolitan cities buy for anything ranging from 15 to 20 rupees a kilo, are often thrown on the roads. Packets or whole bundles of potato are thrown on the roads by farmers because the price fetched in the local market is 50 paisa a kilo. This is a criminal waste. It is not only kind of insult to the farmer, but it's a criminal waste of food. It has to be ensured that farmer gets remunerated price and people get to buy vegetables and food grain at affordable prices. This is part of the government scheme this year, and I must compliment the government for announcing a major thrust to food processing. Children of our kisans have been denied the opportunities that their urban counterparts have enjoyed. Therefore, as part of the Prime Minister's visionary skill development program, the Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushal Yojana has been launched, dovetailed with the Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana that my friend Mr. Yadav just spoke about. Once these two schemes come together and we offer and afford the son of the farmer, the daughter of the farmer, the facilities to upgrade their skills, they will get employability, and that in turn will help the farmers' families get a higher income and prosper. Skill development is the key to better livelihood for both the rural and urban poor. Under the Hunar Hai to Kalyan Hai theme, entrepreneurship skills will be imparted to lakhs of youth. Private corporates are being encouraged to channelize the CSR funds to skill development programs. The government's objective is to ensure equality of opportunity for all so that social and economic disparities can be progressively eradicated. As I said at the outset, the problem with India's growth model, despite all the words of socialist wisdom that we have heard for years, has been that disparities have grown instead of reducing. This government has taken serious initiatives to ensure that these disparities come down and people get equality of opportunity. The Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana has been an outstanding success, demonstrating that financial inclusion was a crying need all these years but was neglected. The scheme reiterates the government's passion to ensure equality for all. In a democracy, sir, equality must not only be in the eyes of God or in the eyes of law, equality also has to be in terms of economic opportunity, and that is what financial inclusion is providing. Essence of India's civilizational values is Sarvajan Hitai, Sarvajan Sukhai. As keeping this in mind, the government has announced taking up wide-ranging programs for health and housing to ensure housing for all by the 75th anniversary of India's independence. At the core of all these programs, ultimately, is the Swachh Bharat Mission. Because if you have a clean India, it's not only that it becomes physically clean, but your mind is cleaner. Once the mind is cleaner, newer and better thoughts, cleaner thoughts, come into the mind and development progresses. Apart from all the new innovative and dynamic schemes covering every arena of human activity and national need, from defense of our frontiers, internal security, conquest of space as demonstrated through Chandrayaan and the spectacular success of Mangalyaan, development of the manufacturing sector through the visionary Make in India project, protection of the environment and wildlife, and conservation of national heritage and promotion of tourism, the President has outlined a holistic vision for 21st century India, which is the government's essential belief. But this vision can succeed only if we, the people of India, remain united and committed to collectively achieve the goal of making India an economic and spiritual superpower. There is no scope for dividing people of this country along fissiparious lines. This government is committed to using all forces at its command to keep India united and make it strong. While defending the democratic rights of people to express their opinion freely, nobody will be allowed to cause disharmony. We cannot allow such forces to deflect us from the goal of unity and prosperity. We must collectively imbibe the mantra, Nanak ki is dharti ko, Gautam ki is bhumi ko, sapno se bhi pyara Hindustan banaye, chodo kal ki baatein, kal ki baat purani, naye daur mein likhenge, milkar nayi kahani, hum Hindustani. Dhanyawad. Thank you.
Thank you, Sri Chandan.